I've made video upon video upon video about this software and about this event happening, and I can't believe the day has finally come.
No.
Gimp 3.
No.
Gimp 3.
She's real!
Gimp 3 is actually here. This is not a drill. This is not a release candidate. This is not, we plan to release it in a few weeks or a few days at some random event. This right here is the Gimp repo. And this right here is the tagged, actual released version of Gimp 3. Now, I can't speak for every single distro available, but over here in Archland, we do have the latest package available. Be sure to check with your specific distro, though. And if you prefer something a bit more official, there is both an official flat pack or an official app image. Now, if you just use GIMP 2 this entire time, there is going to be a lot of major changes. If you've been following the RCs, though, it's basically the state of the RCs, because that's sort of what the point of an RC is. Let's take a look, though. And here it is. It's GIMP. If you're expecting some major UI rework, you were expecting the wrong thing, because that was never going to happen. The main redesign here is going from GTK 2 to GTK 3. Now, if you are a photo GIMP enjoyer, that is also available for GIMP 3 as well. It has been updated, so feel free to go and use that if that is the way you prefer to use it instead. As always, with photo GIMP, you don't need to use the entirety of it. If you just want to take the UI layout and the keybinds and things like that, that is an option you can do instead. Now, regarding the whole GTK 2 to GTK 3 thing, unless you're a programming nerd, frankly, doesn't really mean that much. Basically, it is old toolkit to new toolkit. It looks a little bit smoother. It's a little bit faster in places. It also has native Wayland support. So now this isn't running as an X Wayland window. If I go and open up my favorite ways to test this, that would be with X eyes. If we hover over the window, it is using Wayland. Does it really matter that much to you? Not really, because the X Wayland version was working pretty well anyway. But don't be tricked into thinking that absolutely nothing has changed. Very far from the case. Let's talk about the layers. Now, you might notice this new icon right here. We'll get to that in just a moment. Firstly, though, let's do something absolutely crazy in GIMP. Let's hold down the shift button and click this layer. Multiple items selected. Multi-layer selection. Okay, let's click this layer and then go control click, control click, control click. You might not know why this is so exciting. This wasn't available in GIMP before. I know this is like a standard feature in most applications with multiple items to interact with, but it wasn't in GIMP. But it's not just selecting them, that would be pretty useless. If we go and select this one to this one, go to the move tool, we can move them together. This is something you could already do by abusing the way that groups worked, but now, like everything else, you can just select the things and they work. Now, some things don't behave entirely as you'd expect. If I try to delete this group, or delete the content in the group, it won't modify the layer group. For some reason, that's being treated as a different thing. If I had selected the actual layers in the group, that will work, but not the parent itself, which seems a bit odd to me. Also, this should be working, but you're not able to apply effects to a group. This was working during one of the RCs. I don't entirely know why it stopped working. This is still a work in progress, but as it stands, at least being able to interact with multiple layers is better than it was before. Now, regarding effects, regarding filters, let's talk about the new little icon available in the layer list. It's a little FX for layer effects. This has all of the effects currently applied to that layer. So right now we have drop shadow, giggle effects, and brightness dash contrast. Let's go and add a human saturation. Let's do this. Okay, but what can we do with the icon here? Well, This now supports non-destructive editing. So if I click on the button, I can now go and, let's say, get rid of the drop shadow or get rid of the brightness and contrast, which isn't a major difference. Let's say the giggle effects for the border here. Or, even better, I can click on one of them, click on this button, and edit it. I don't have to go and undo the effect, nothing like that. I can just edit them as much as I want. I can do whatever I want to it, and it's fine. I can even go and get rid of an effect, or reorder an effect. No longer do I need to keep around multiple copies of a layer, so if I want to go and undo an effect, I have to do the entire effect stack again. No, not even remotely anymore. I can now just do it non-destructively. Now, not everything is non-destructive. You'll know it's non-destructive if it appears in this list. So, obviously, things like painting over a layer is considered destructive. Basically, if it's something that is going to appear in the filter list, it's almost certainly going to be non-destructive. Now, whilst on the topic of filters, there are some filters which, in most other image editors, are considered really basic and been there for a very, very long time, and now are actually present in GIMP. If we search inner glow, or bevel, or there's a catch-all for doing a bunch of other random things called giggle styles. Now, one thing to note about inner glow is it doesn't work the way you might expect it to. It makes an inner glow, but an inner glow of the shape. So, if you actually want this to be an inner glow on the thing that you're actually applying it to, you need to either duplicate the layer or select the border and then go and apply the effect to that. It's a little bit weird and I don't like it. I don't really know why it's done like this. I'm sure there's a technical reason for it. It just feels a lot less intuitive. Now, on my system, you will notice a lot of effects that aren't actually available in the regular version of GIMP. Things like giggle effects here. So, I also make use of additional effects that come from this repo right here. And I would highly recommend this if you want a bunch of just additional random things. Things which I guess you could put into GIMP, but don't really necessarily fit with the core structure. All of these are available. There's a ton of filters here. I would recommend checking it out. Now, one thing most of you won't be using, but for those who do, it is very, very important, is GIMP has been massively improving its color space support. So all over the place where colors are used, you'll see references to the current profile being used. Of course, right now for me, it's sRGB because that's fine, I'm not doing print, so sRGB is totally good. But for those of you where color is very important and you need to work in a very specific color space, there are settings here now. The settings have been greatly expanded over the time that we've had these RCs, over the time we've had 2.99, and I don't need to use this. I don't entirely know the full requirements of what you want, but this is something that GIMP actually is taking seriously as a thing and a use case that people have with an image editor. If you'd like to follow the work being done on the color space improvements, this is known as space invasion. And if you're in an industry where using this actually needs to be done, or even just you're personally doing something where color space is very important, please do get involved in the issue tracking, report any issues you find, mention things that you want to be available, and hopefully this can be further improved, because this has always been one of the things where people say GIMP is just entirely useless. You can't do professional work with GIMP, you can't do color management. They're actually working on it, and a lot of things are in place now. And far less important to most people, but far more important to me, is the redesign of Wilbur. I am so happy they didn't go with this, like, modern, clean, simplistic design. It's still Wilbur. It's a cleaner Wilbur, it's a more minimalistic Wilbur, but it's still clearly Wilbur. I saw some of the suggestions people had in some of the issue tracking, and no, Some of it was just like modern, bland gnome icon design, and I'm so happy this is not what was done. What I've talked about so far is by no means a full, extensive list of changes. Even the release notes is not a full, extensive list of changes between 2.10 and 3.0. But if you'd like to have a better idea of what actually has changed, this is the best place to go to. There is so many things. A lot of them aren't even, you know, visible to the user. A lot of them are like back-end things like, we have a new plugin system. There's been API improvements. There's an experimental tool called Paint Select where you can just like paint around an object and select it. It's still buggy, so it's not enabled by default. There's just general improved tech support. We now have a thing called auto-expanding layers in here? No, it's not. No, it is. It just has a dash in it, where you can set this feature, and as you paint around an object, the layer will expand as you paint. Personally, don't really think it's that useful. I use the entire canvas the entire time, but for those who do want to see something like that, now you can play around with that. If the last time you used GIMP was 2.10, give 3.0 a try, because there's going to be a lot of things where they're just no longer issues anymore. It's been that long between these releases that you're in for a surprise. Now, going forward, this is very important because yes, there has been the 3.0 release, but this is not the end of the project. What happens now? Going forward, we will only introduce new features during minor releases, such as GIMP 3.2 and 3.0.x releases will be reserved for bug fixes as it used to be until GIMP 2.8. But this is the key point. However, we also intend for minor releases to be much more frequent. Rather than having another 6+ years of development schedule for GIMP 3.2, we plan to release it within a year of 3.0. As a result, it will include less features, but those features will be available to users much sooner. We've already set up several feature groups in our post 3.0 roadmap, each of which might become a new GIMP 3.x release. Several features already have initial code developed and posted for review, and we're looking forward to discussing those more in future news posts. If you'd like to go check those out on the roadmap, I've showed the roadmap before, but here it is, and I'll link it down below. Now, just because someone's going to ask about it, hey, what about the shape tool? When's the shape tool going to happen? Well, the shape tool is going to require rework of their vector tooling. So whenever that happens, then the shape tool can be considered. But also, it's not really considered a big priority for the project anyway. And if you go to art forums and ask about the shape tool, you're probably going to be laughed at because a shape tool and these actual useful image editing features are for two completely different class of users. If this release model is how they'd always been doing it, yeah, there'd still be jokes like, oh, it's on GTK 2 still, when's GIMP 3 gonna come out? But at least people would be less bothered as they're at least getting new functionality. And of course, people are gonna start asking, hey, where's GIMP 4? It's in GTK 3, GTK 3 is already out of date. As I said earlier, the toolkit doesn't really matter to the users of the software. They care more about the functionality, and maybe at some point it will be in GTK 4, maybe at some point it'll migrate to something else, maybe at some point there'll be like a fork of GTK 3, which I know some desktops are considering working on, and it entirely moves off of the GNOME-directed GTK line. I don't know how it's gonna go, but at least for now, GIMP 3 is here, and I love it. I've been using the RCs and 299 for a while. It's great, but what do you think? Do you care about GIMP 3? Were you already using the RCs in 2.99? Or do you think 2.10 was fine? I'd love to know. So if you liked the video, go like the video. If you really liked the video and you want to become one of these amazing people over here, check out the Patreon, subscribe, and Libero Pay linked in the description down below. That's going to be it for me, and wouldn't you know it, the name discussion has started back up again. It's dumb. It'll always be dumb. And that's the last I'm going to say on it.
What is...